Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I decided to film 3 more looks with the most hyped and amazing palette of 2021 from an indie makeup brand, and this is the Club Nebula palette from Kaleidos Makeup in collaboration with Angelica Newquist, and I will link the channel just here. I already filmed a video with my first impressions of the palette, and I think the palette is amazing. I will link the video here so you can see it. The palette is coming back in stock in May, so this is the third makeup look for today. It's gonna be the last one you'll see in this video, and I'm gonna love you and leave you with all the makeup looks. But if we don't know each other, my name is Val and I love everything makeup and beauty. So if you wanna stick around, just press the subscribe button and ring the small bell so you can get notified every time I upload a new video. And now, without any further ado, I'm leaving you with the first one and I'll see you in the end with this makeup look. Okay, starting off with the first look, this one will be quite soft. I think I wanna use this Nebula shade here together with some US and then a little bit of the Celestial shade. Maybe, just maybe, in the end, I will darken the outer corner with the Red Giant. Okay, that's a bit zoomed in and I hope it's gonna be easier for you to see. But I'm just using the Sam US shade, this peachy shade, just in the crease. I'm gonna take a smaller brush though, because this one is definitely too big. It's one of my favorite brushes from Inglot, by the way. But it's quite big really, it's 6SS, this one. So I switch it to the Sigma one, which is the A25. And I love the way this shade looks. I decided that I will use some of the Red Giant just in the outer corner. And it looks so beautiful that I feel sorry to touch it. But I'm just gonna apply the tiniest bit here in the outer corner. And I'll just keep switching in between the colors just to blend everything together. But the two colors look amazing when you use them together, when you blend them with each other. You just need the slightest tiny, the most gentle touch and dipping the brush in the palette, because the pigmentation is huge. And I'm moving into the Nebula shade, which I'm so excited for, and then Celestial, of course. Ooh. Wait, before I forget, I will apply some more powder just here under in my T-zone, because the last time I had some fallout here and I don't really like this. Oh, that's beautiful. This looks like something in between peach, gold, pink. Now I'm gonna take some of the Celestial shade. Oh guys, this is stunning. This is now much cooler tone, undertone than the Nebula. It looks a lot more pink. I hope you're probably able to see how it looks, but it's just, ooh, gorgeous. So I applied the tiniest bit of Sam US in the inner corner, and then I'm topping it with the Nova shade. And it looks amazing. Now, because I want to mix everything, always, I will apply some of the Nebula shade as well on top. Okay, I really start to feel like I'm working in a makeup laboratory and I create my own colors, which is awesome. That's what you're getting with this palette anyway, as I said before. On the lower lash line, I'm just gonna use the tiniest bit of Sam US, just in the outer corner, more likely, probably, because I don't want to put anything in the waterline. Last night, I filmed a video for my Bulgarian channel, and I did my lower lid and my lower lash line. I did put a liner again, and 10 minutes after, my eyes were watering so badly. It just doesn't make sense for me. As I said, I need to go out and I won't be able to touch up my liner all of the time, and it's just extremely annoying because it's like a 2 millimeters of here, this part of my waterline, where it just goes clear in like not even 10 minutes. Plus, as I've said before, I often do just my upper lid and do some mascara on the lower lid. By the way, one of the reasons for this is probably because before I do my eyelid surgery, I always used to notice that as soon as I put something on my lower lid, the attention was going there and my eye bags were so huge that you could like maybe if I wouldn't apply anything on the lower lid, you wouldn't be able to notice my eye bags so in your face. But as soon as I do something on the lower lid, it was like, boom, I'm gonna do some mascara and a bit of lashes. I don't want to do any eyeliner, but I wanna use some lashes today just because for the last few days I'm trying to start wearing eyelashes again, and I'm testing out how I feel, you know, how my eyes feel like. Like last night I had lashes for about an hour, maybe 2 hours or something. It was okay. I didn't have any problems with the glue, you know, when removing the lashes and etc. Okay, it's a bit hard to put them on just because I don't feel the place. It just feels numb. It's really weird to put them on, but at least I didn't have any problems when I removed them or the next day or something. So I'll do some mascara, lashes, and I'm coming back to you in a second. There we go, guys. This is the finished makeup look. I just love the look with this palette. Honestly, it looks so feminine and gentle, and in the same time you can do, I mean, like last time you saw with the blue, you can go really dark and you can go grungy. I'm sure the green will be awesome as well. And maybe that's what I'm gonna do next. We'll see that. So I'm gonna love you and leave you guys and see you with the next look. Okay, time for the second look today. And I was initially planning to do like two eyes, a different makeup look, just to use more shades. But I think I might need to leave the house. Anyway, I'm gonna go for a green look. And for this, I match it with my sweater, which I got from the charity shop. It's River Island, by the way. But I really like the, how do you call this, olive green. And that's like a lime shade. I have my eyelids prepped already. I used the Be Perfect primer. And let's try the gravity in the crease and see what happens. I'm really, really nervous about this, honestly. Oh, that's really gentle, by the way. It definitely looks soft on the eyes. I mean, it's bright, but it's soft in the same time. Muted, if that makes sense. I'm really enjoying this green so far. Okay, I'm gonna move on to the Queen of Blades, the dark green shade. I need a smaller brush for the purpose. Wow, you just barely need to touch the brush in the pan. Okay, that's so pigmented, guys. And it's beautiful green, to be honest. Just look at that. I just barely touched my skin with the brush. You see, that's the thing which I'm most happy about this palette, because the dark shades so far perform amazingly, and this is really important for me. I like using dark here in the outer corner, especially now when you can still see my scars. So for me, the dark shades are really, really important. And I'm gonna go back to the bigger brush so I can blend the edges softly. Be honest, I love that so far. The only thing I don't like is that this shade of green, it's not the shadows, it's not the way that they blend. My scars look a bit more visible, at least here with the lights. Probably outside in daylight it won't be that obvious, but it's just highlighting them in some way. But that's just the color, not the shades. I will just pass with a completely clean brush here, just to blend out any other edges. Okay, that's motorbike and it's loud. And it's actually my boyfriend. And let's move on to the Firefly shade, which I'm most scared for. I mean, I'm joking, I'm not scared. Now when I think, actually, while I'm here on the dark green, I will do some on the lower lash line. And I'll smoke it out with a bit of gravity again. You see, that's the funny thing. When I touch my skin with the brush, the color, the shadows seems to disperse around my small tiny scars. And this is so annoying. It's like I don't have any control here. I need to clean the mess up all the time now. Quite grungy, really. But let's go in with the Firefly and see what happens. I'm so curious. I'm gonna spray the brush. I knew it. Wow. This is so beautiful. Honestly, guys. That's exactly why I wanted to film this look separately, and just so you get my first impression from most of the colors. And I will definitely start wearing green more often. I mean, this kind of green. I'm using the same firefly shade. This is it looks like a small stone here in the inner corner. And I'm gonna bring it here a little bit further in. Oh, I like that a lot. It's amazing. Honestly, it's amazing. So I'm gonna finish off my eyes with some mascara, liner, I'm not sure, lashes, probably. Something in the waterline, and I'm coming back to you just in a second. Okay guys, this is the finished makeup look. I did the tiniest bit of eyeliner and these false lashes I don't like, but I don't have other ones right now. I need to order some new model, but this is how everything looks like. And in the waterline I use the We Makeup green pencil, which I'm loving, the green and the blue one. And this is how everything looks like. But anyway, don't forget to let me know down in the comments, what do you think? Do you like it? Do you think I should wear this kind of greens more often or no? And I'll see you soon with the third look. Okay guys, time for the third look. And this one, you've probably noticed from the intro, is a bit more different and a bit more, you know, not an everyday makeup look. I'm gonna start off with the void shade just in the outer corner and see what comes next, because I don't have any idea what I want to do right now. I just feel inspired for something a bit more like, you know, something different. I prime my lids with eye primer from Be Perfect again. I definitely enjoy this void shade a lot. I told you in my first video, I think. I will try to grab this smaller brush and I'm gonna go in with this Samus shade. I actually wanna keep this shade just on top of the blue. Just to get a bit more of a orange hue on the border here, I will mix just a tiniest bit of red giant just around the edges here. And I'm gonna bring this red giant just a bit further in. I'm going back to Samus shade on top, obviously, here again. Because I lost some of it. I'm just mixing both of them, Red Giant and Samus, and blend the edge again. And I'm taking mixture of the Red Giant and the Samus again, and I will smoke the lower lash up to here, because I'm not sure what I'm gonna do further in. I will take some more of the Samus shade and bring it in my brow bone. In my brow, not my brow bone, in my brow, actually. Now, I want to bring this Samus shade here, mixed with the Red Giant a bit more, but still leave this space, if that makes any sense. I'm gonna dip in Cylon, because the last time I couldn't use it, and I'm gonna start to build it just a bit more inwards, like a bit on top of the blue, on top of void, but then move it, like bring it more to the center of the lid. Now I need the pointier brush. Just try to bring the Cylon shade under the Red Giant here in the inner corner, in the inner part of the eye, actually. You know what I mean, I guess. Okay, this is gonna be the longest look in this video, I am already sure. Okay, now I will try to clean off everything here and create like a cut crease shape. I'm gonna apply the Nebula shade. Next, I wanna use some of the Celestial shade just here. Oh, gorgeous. And now, just with my brush straight, I will use some of the Celestial shade here. So, I am taking some of the Nova shade and I bring it here just want to line this ever so slightly. Okay, next up I'm gonna do some of the celestial shade just here. And then I'm gonna go on top of it with Nebula shade. Now with the same fluffy brush, I'm taking some of the Nova shade without spraying the shade, because I want to get some of it on top of the purple here, just a bit more, like more sparkles effect. I know it's gonna fall out a bit, but that's fine. Okay, let's finish off the lower lash line, and I'm gonna use 7 of 9 for a bit of pop here. And I'm gonna try to mix it here in the middle with the void. And then take some of the cyclone under the void. And I'm taking some of the firefly shade just in the inner corner here. So I finally decided to leave the eyeliner off, because otherwise it was going to completely hide the shape which I tried to create, you know, something different. I went in just with the lashes, and then on my in my waterline I used the two pencils from We Makeup, the green and the blue, and I used the void shade and the Queen of Blades on top of them just to set them a bit, even though my outer corners will be gone just in a few minutes. I really like how this turned out. It's completely different, not your everyday makeup look, if that makes sense. And the fact that you can go for so dramatic look and in the same time use it for like an everyday makeup looks, it's just awesome for me. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful and inspiring. If you own the palette and you wanna, you know, like do some more looks with it. And yeah, I'll see you in my next one. Bye!